Welcome, fremde, étranger. All I need is one good break, just one good break, then, mister, watch
my life is what you do while you're waiting to die.
Remember the day you found the dollar bill, or roller skating down the hill, the happy time.
What a charge, Kate, in the atmosphere. $50 a plate for the woman of the year.
That I was gonna do. See the difference? Fred, Johnny, okay so far? You feel good? Yeah, I thought it was gonna be an actual slideshow. Is this the names of your shows? What is that? I mean, it's their nice names, but a little picture of Cheetah, Eliza, Joel maybe? I don't know. Next year I'll produce it. We'll do another one. Bigger, better, a whole rink. It'll be fabulous. These two gentlemen that we're honoring tonight have collaborated for over 35 years. Fairly amazing achievement in and of itself. Have 3 Tony Awards, 2 Emmys, a Grammy, and they wrote the official anthem for New York City. All right, stop. We already told them Liza wasn't here, and let's not rub it in, okay? She's not here. She was gonna do it. It would have been fabulous. She probably would have went, she's not here, so it ain't gonna happen, you know? She's limping somewhere in very big pain, I'm pretty sure. If it was me, unless I was in a coma after what you did for her, if you did that, if you wrote me a, it's Rosie with an R, not Rosie with an R, you know, I would have been here unless I was in a coma. That whole goddamn Liza Minnelli song. They only do the first, and that is only half of it. There's another way they treat me cruelly. How often I remember someone saying, there she goes, Lisa Minnelli. I'm an Oli, I'm an Eola, I'm an Ali, I'm an Eli. So is it a wonder? I very often cry. See, it's my double M, that it'll lie. You're double up again. That's not in that area. And it'll lie. That's what I'm saying, Minnelli. Liza Minnelli. It's Italian. Blaming her papa. What can I do? Every Sandra, who's a Sandra? Every Mary, who's really Marie? Every Joan, who is a Joanne? Has got to agree with me when I announce I don't mind being trampled or trampled or trounced, but it does drive you back to be mispronounced. That's where she would have been better. She has the high note. This season, you guys are ever present on Broadway, as we all know, with the fabulous Fran and Barry Weisler production of the revival of Chicago, which I absolutely love, and the brilliant new musical, Steel Pier. I saw it opening night, and it was fabulous, although that Karen Zaniba bitch, I could have done it. I don't know. Perhaps you thought I was busy with my show? You concerned about the dancing on the roof number? Phone me, boys, okay? Think, Rosie. Whatever. What these two men do share is a commitment to quality and excellence. You never do what we expect, and you take us on some amazing journeys because of that. Through the heart, through our minds, with intelligence and passion, stories that we did not expect to be told. And you're just two guys who got together to write songs, lots of songs, and we're going to celebrate them here with you and for you this evening. The first one is a trunk song that really has never been performed anywhere. And the second one, well, I think you might recognize it. Maestro on the working piano, hit it.
What am I doing in Cleveland when I ought to be in Pittsburgh? I should have been in Pittsburgh a week or so ago, but here I am sticking in Cleveland when I ought to go to Pittsburgh. I'm overdoing Pittsburgh. I know, but oh my, oh, here in Ohio, there's a dreamy mist
with a steamy kiss.
Well, I have been a salesman all my life, but I acted like a baby in the woods.
Oh, and she sold me a bill of goods.
So here I am sitting in Cleveland when I ought to go to Pittsburgh. I gotta go to Pittsburgh, but I'm having such a ball that I may never
get to Pittsburgh.
Never get to Pittsburgh.
Never get to Pittsburgh.
I said, never get to Pittsburgh. I may never get to Pittsburgh at all. A steamy kiss. Well, I have been a salesman all my life, but I acted like a baby in the woods.
Oh, and she sold me a bill of goods.
So here I am sitting in Cleveland when I ought to go to Pittsburgh. I've got to go to Pittsburgh, but I've had this much of all that I may never
get to Pittsburgh.
Never get to Pittsburgh.
Never get to Pittsburgh.
I said, never get to Pittsburgh.
Ladies and gentlemen, Donna Murphy.
In case you fancy coloring books, and lots of people do, I've a new one for you. A most unusual coloring book, the kind you never see. Crayons ready, very well, begin to color me. These are the eyes that watched him as he walked away. This is the heart that thought he would always be true. Color it blue. These are the arms that held you and touched you, that lost you somehow. Color them empty now. These are the things I wore until she came between.
So I do what I do when I'm through.
then I'm through, and I'm through. Toodaloo. Bye-bye, my lily. The hair, farewell, my lily. The hair, it was a fine affair, but now it's over. And though I used to care, I need the open air. You're better off without me, my hair. Don't dab your eye, my hair. I wonder why my hair. I've always said that I was a rover. You mustn't knit your brow. You should have known by now. You've every cause to doubt me, my hair. The continent of Europe is so wide, my hair. Not only up and down, but side to side, my hair. I couldn't ever cross it if I tried. My hair, but I do what I can, inch by inch, step by step, mile by mile, man by man. Bye, bye.
And green, the Rhine gives its gold to what you're thinking. You wonder why I chose her out of all the ladies in the world. That's just the first impression. What good's the first impression? If you knew her like I do, it would change your point of view. If you could see her through my eyes, you wouldn't wonder at all. If you could see her through my eyes, I guarantee you would fall like I did when we're in public together. I hear society moan, oh sweetheart, but if they could see her through my eyes, maybe they'd leave us alone. Tickle, tickle. Tickle, tickle. Woohoo! How can I speak of her virtues? I don't know where to begin. She's clever, she smiles, she reads music. She doesn't smoke or drink gin like I do, yet when we're walking together, they sneer if I'm holding her hand. But if they could see her through my eyes, maybe they'd all understand. I grant you the problem's not small, but if you could see her so my eyes, she wouldn't look Jewish at all.
Is the tiara too much? I agonized over it. I made this. That's what I'm doing lately. I have them in all colors. You can never get enough of a good thing. Speaking of good things, hi, Fred. Hi, John. People have asked me if Freddie and John ever wrote anything for me. And my reply is, actually, everything they wrote for me. I just never got the job. I'm going to be out in the lobby later. Signing my book, How I Survived the Boer War. And I'm selling patterns. Anyway, they call me Star Baby, Fred and John. They gave me that name. Freddie gave it to me. That was in 1958. It's a long time ago. And we've been friends ever since. Now I'm going to do something else. It's from 1958. Excuse me. I like to see where I've been. There's a lady living somewhere. Where it is, I do not know. But I long to write and tell her that I love her so. I'm afraid I might do mayhem, and I might destroy myself if I ever found her missing from my grocer's shelf.
Just fractures me. Give me a taste of your German chocolate. I love my mother, but you can't compare her, not with Sarah. See, she's a plain girl, Sarah Lee. She's like her pound cake. There's no H, just Sarah. Hey, but that's okay by me, 'cause I'm living in paradise when I'm chewing that apple spice from the kisses of my lovely Sarah Lee. Take it away, boy. And I'm thinking, for goodness sake, there's never been a better banana cake. 'Cause that Milton, he works at the Hilton. He caters banquets at each affair he'll swear by. Chocolate swirl from the kitchens up to what I love.
Oh. Wonderful Sarah, beautiful Sarah.
Give me an S, A, R, A, no H, L, E, E. Give that Sarah. Oh, she's too good for this world.
saw four times original Annie, six. I met her backstage and she said, you don't know me, but I thought, bullshit, I know your whole career. I love her. Isn't she the greatest? You don't know what it is for me. Grew up on Long Island, used to take the train in with money I stole from my father and see these plays over and over again. And to meet the people that I saw on stage there, it's a very overwhelming feeling for this little girl from Comac, I have to tell you that much. John, Fred, and I hope you don't mind the familiarity. You know, you guys are very successful, and I know money's not a problem, but I was thinking, there's a way for you guys to incorporate all of your musical ability with a fine product that does not yet have a jingle. I don't even think you would have to do just change a few words, like take ringdings, a snack cake that I'm very fond of. I just whipped this together. Would you? You know I love ringdings, they're things they call ringdings. I love a date who brings a carton of ringdings. It's like a dream Drake's dreamt, it makes me so verklempt. You know I love ringdings. Think of the money, you guys. Think of the money. I'm just saying. All right, we're going to go on with the auction now. It is very late. We got $1,000 from the piano tuners. Fuck up for the walk-on roll on Victoria, Victor, whatever. We have an announcer of the Rosie O'Donnell Show. It's a program you may be familiar with. Chubby loudmouth girl. On and on. You get to go on the show. You get to do the opening announce. You get two denim jackets that say the Rosie O'Donnell Show on them. And you get to, I don't know, whatever else you want.
I'm just fine.
You look beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
How's everything going?
Oh, just fine.
Oh, you're so fabulous.
Oh, thank you. I'm hot.
You're hot?
Yeah,
you are. You sure are. Yeah. I know, because you were on my show.
I got 51 phone calls
51?
After that. Yeah, I went home, there were 51 messages.
Wow, so you did great.
That's a big popular show.
It is, yes. Yeah. Then you're a popular singer.
Yeah, I'm hot.
You're hot. There you go. Yes, you are. All righty. Now, you're going to sing, of course, probably something from Chicago.
Oh, no, no.
Oh, no.
No, I'm not going to sing anything from Chicago.
Oh, no.
No, I'd like to do a song about death.
Death?
Death.
Really?
Well, you know, we've got to face it sooner or later. We're getting older, you know?
Yeah.
And, well, it's just there.
It's there.
Looming.
Looming.
And luckily, Fred and John wrote a song about it.
They did?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That would be in 70 Girls 70, 1971, Broadhurst Theater, Mildred Natwick.
Rosie, you've got a memory like an elephant.
Sound cue. Marsha Lewis, the elephant song.
When a person dies, he's put in the ground, and all his relatives gather around, and he gets a little stone, and he gets a little mound, where the ivy likes to grow. Tell me, how many graves have you seen so far? When you're riding by in your motor car, you can spot where all dead people are. But this is what I'm dying to know. Where does an elephant go? Where does an elephant go? When an elephant gets so old and gray that the poor thing's gotta be put away, well, if somebody knows, won't somebody say? Where does an elephant go? When Hannibal's elephants made that track way over the Alps to a Roman sack, surely one of them had a heart attack. Where did that elephant go?
Where did that elephant go?
Oh, that's very, very nice, boys. Yeah, seriously. What if the Weislers decide to revive Jumbo? When the pharaohs roamed in a biblical land to keep those Nubians well in hand, there were lots of elephants, I understand, everywhere you go. There were elephants came from Kipling's pen. There were elephants there since God knows when. So a hell of a lot must have died since then. And here is what I'm longing to know.
Here
an elephant go?
Oh.
Where does an elephant go? When a pharaoh finally meets his doom, they lay him out in a swanky tomb. But an elephant takes so damn much room. Where does an elephant go? Now, I want to tell you something, something that happened to me once. Every day of my life, I used to like to go up to the zoo, you know, the one in Central Park, and I would feed this elephant. Oh, I'd buy her salted peanuts and things, and I would feed her, and she was real cute, and I really enjoyed it. Well, one day I went up there, and the elephant was missing. Missing! Well, I got all nervous and all upset, and I started yelling, Mr. Billings! Mr. Billings! He's the zookeeper. I said, Mr. Billings, what happened to Patsy? Where is she? Well, Mr. Billings said, Patsy died. She had a coronary thrombosis, and she is dead. Well, I said, where did you take her? I mean, where
did you put her?
And I said, what'd you have, the Santini brothers up here or something? Well, he started getting all nervous and everything and busy. He had to run off and feed the snakes and the hippopotami. And there I was just standing there yelling, Mr. Billings, Mr. Billings, you have got to tell me. You have got to answer me. Where did the elephant go? Tree in a shady spot, but an elephant needs a parking lot. Where does an elephant go? When the coffin's closed and the lid is firm, a man's consigned to the pine and worm. But what kind of box fits a pachyderm?
Where does an elephant go?
When an elephant sees his final dawn, when an elephant's final breath is drawn, it's a cinch, there ain't no forest lawn. Jeffrey, think about that next time you're tickling the ivory.
Where does an elephant?
Where does an elephant?
Where does that elephant?
Where does an elephant go?
As the days go, dear one,
when you feel you've gone to hell in a handbasket, and the world in which you dwell is no paradise.
Ladies and gentlemen, Chita Rivera.
I've some counsel I can give, you need but ask it. I'm so very glad to share this good advice. You've got to learn how not to be where you are. The more you face reality, the more you scar. So close your eyes and you can be a movie star. Why must you stay where you are? You've got to learn how not to see what you see. The slice of hell you call your life is harsh and mean. So why not lie beside me on a movie screen? Why must you see what you see? And if you find that you land in jail, a little fantasy will not fail. It's just as simple as ABC. Come up here, play with me, play with me. You got to learn how not to do what you've done. The pistol shot can't kill if you unload the gun. So build a palace for you're the Shah, and we'll embrace in that Shangri-La. If you run away some matinee from where you are.
Thank you.
Chita Rivera, ladies and gentlemen. Hi. I didn't know. I thought maybe. Hit the music, damn it!
What are you doing?
Here's to the ring.
You wouldn't dare.
And both of us together.
And both of us together.
I'll drink to that.
I'll drink to that.
I'll drink to that. I'll drink to that. Oh, this is good. You want to do this one?
I don't know.
Come on.
So find yourself some other place and don't. Oh, mommy, I've heard it all my life and I don't need to hear it now.
Mama,
oh, Jesus.
It's like it was before. I just walked through the door and right away you start to fight and curse.
That's bullshit.
Ma, bullshit. I thought there'd be some tears that after all these years you might have mellowed some. Jesus, was I dumb?
So you thought I might be calm, maybe jolly you along. Well, believe me, I'm not calm, and believe me, you were wrong. Should the sound of your hello be like music to my ears when I haven't seen your face in, what is it, 7 years? Welcome home, my little pig. Boy, you really got a big set of balls.
Mama!
Oh, some balls.
Mama!
It's true.
I like the ball part. Yeah, this is good. This is your big number, take
big, it. No.
If you don't do it, I will. I swear to you,
Chita. Oh, no, you won't either.
All right, go ahead.
Chief cook and bottle washer. That's what I always was. Doing what some cook and bottle washer does.
Wah, wah, wah.
Go stand and take the tickets. Go make the corn go pop. Bread to bake.
And beds to make.
And rugs to shake. And floors to mop.
You were so good in this one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Gee, it's good to see you after all these years.
I didn't do that one.
I know. Gee, you really lifted my morale. Come on, go ahead.
Keeping it together after all these years.
What's your secret, old pal?
I'll tell you.
Go ahead, tell me.
Never be a wallflower sitting in a chair up against the wall waiting for some boy to say,
how about a twirl?
Not my little girl.
No, not me, mama.
You've got to stand, baby, tall and proud. Get noticed by the crowd. Shake, baby, make a fuss. And you can be a whiz the way your mama wants.
Wah, wah, wah. What happened to the old days?
What happened to the movie shows? Why is it that it's only safe to see a matinee?
What's going on?
What's going on?
What's going on? Nowadays you look at bulging trousers.
I know. Some boy with bulging trousers. And it isn't what you think it is. The bastard's got a gun.
It's murder. Oh, yes. This is my favorite number. You're getting stoned. They're taking out the organ. It's Liza or Chita, whichever one.
She's scary.
I don't know. And now you she and me, we did you. Gary, I hate Mr. Whipple.
Well, I don't know about God. Me too.
Uh-huh.
I hate growing older.
Boy, am I with you.
You don't have to be a professor to see. The apple doesn't fall very far from the tree.
Me, I like to stroke some big guy's chest.
Especially Italian.
Mama, they're the best.
You don't need a sheepskin from Harvard to see. The apple doesn't fall very far from the tree.
Listen to this.
What?
For 9 months.
Yeah.
At least I was never ignored.
babies.
Go ahead, be my guest.
We're not so very different.
Now I'm real depressed.
Well, you open a tea bag, there's gonna be tea. You open a pea pot, and guess what?
What?
A pea.
That's right.
The apple doesn't fall very far.
Ladies and gentlemen, James Naughton.
Bye, Caitlin.
Bye, Jimmy.
Fred and John, thank you so much for writing this part. No actor ever had an entrance like Billy Flynn. And you can get used to having those ladies with the feathers follow you around. I've been trying to get them to go shopping with me, but... So thank you very much. Maybe this time I'll be lucky. Maybe this time she'll stay. Maybe this time, for the first time, love won't hurry away. She will hold me fast. I'll be home at last. Not a loser anymore, like the last time or the time before. Everybody loves a winner, so nobody loved me. Mr. Peaceful, Mr. Happy, that's what I long to be. All the odds are in my favor, something's bound to begin. It's gotta time I'll win. Everybody loves a winner, so nobody loved me. Mr. Peaceful, Mr. Happy, that's what I long to be. Maybe this time. Thank you. Fred Ebb was very disappointed that I made it through that song. I told him that I was shaky on the words, and he said, "It's okay, kid. If you have a problem," he says, "I'll come right up there." I said, "What, you're going to wrestle the microphone out of my hand?" He said, "Yeah, yeah." Anyway, it's my pleasure next to introduce, for the very first time here at the Supper Club, a pair of scintillating sinners, those damsels you know so well. I'm not talking Julia Mead, but Roxy Hart and Velma Kelly. Let's hear it for them.
Isn't it great? Isn't it swell? Isn't it fun? Isn't it nowadays?
There's men everywhere, jazz everywhere, booze everywhere, life everywhere, joy everywhere nowadays. You can like the life you're living. You can live the life you like. You can even marry Harry, but mess around with Ike. And that's good. Isn't it grand? Isn't it great? Isn't it swell? Isn't it fun? Isn't it? But nothing stays. In 50 years or so, it's gonna change, you know. But oh, it's heaven nowadays.
Pisses me off in one leg, you know? So elegant. I can't even do the bow. Well, did you enjoy your tribute? Fred, John, we're all here because we love you and you've influenced our lives in a tremendous way. And we're all here also because of the musical theater work, which raised about 40 grand tonight, which is very good for aspiring young musical theater people. Jeff Saver, ladies and gentlemen, the man who couldn't make the piano work. Jeff Saver. Joel, now, right now, is the big finale with Liza Minnelli. Ooh, it was gonna be good. Instead, you got me. Sorry about that. I'll do what I can, Fred. In your programs, you have the words, should you need them. Life is a cabaret, old chum, sung for the first time by Rosie O'Donnell Duck. Give me that note again. What? Okay, everyone, that's the note we're on. What good is sitting alone in your room? Everybody, come hear the music play. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret. That's it. Put down the knitting. I know it. The books and the brew. It's time for a holiday. Life is a cabaret, old chum. So come to the cabaret. That's it. Come taste the wine. This is all me, so don't try to sing, because, you know, she's not here. Screw it. I get a little solo part, don't you think? I used to have a girlfriend known as Elsie, with whom I shared four sordid rooms in Chelsea. She wasn't what you'd call a blushing flower. As a matter of fact, she rented by the hour. The day she died, the neighbors came to snicker. Well, that's what comes from too much pills and liquor. But when I saw her laid out like a queen, Liza would have done that probably. She was the happiest corpse I'd ever seen. I think of Elsie to this very day. I'm sorry, Jeff. I remember, I don't know what key, how she turned to me, helped me, and say, everybody now please get back in, damn it. What good is my mind up back in Chelsea. This would be a big Liza growl, don't you think? When I go. Is a cabaret.
Boy, am I speechless. I don't think I've ever been through anything like this in my whole life. I just want to thank everybody connected with this who brought this about. Music Theater Works. Jeff, where are you? Come out here. Jeff Saver. Everybody connected with it, and a very particular friend of mine, Albert Stevenson, who put this together.
I write the lyrics, and I'm speechless, which may be good for you. We were asked because Liza's, something happened to her hip. I guess you heard a lot about that. And I'll say no more, but John and I would like to close this evening with our enormous thanks. Albert has asked us to sing a song for you. And by God, I'm going to do it. Wait a minute! Carrie Ballard used to say, I've had a request, but I'm going to sing anyway. And, will you wait a minute? God. Cy Coleman is free, you know. But anyway, okay. Now, Johnny.
Now?
Yeah. Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. Vagabond shoes are longing to stray and step around the heart of it, New York, New York. I wanna wake up in the city that doesn't sleep to find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap. Town blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York. If I can make it there, I'd make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York. It's up to you, New York, New York.
Peter, Peter.